Hi. So my name's Jack Norman. I am a very excitable person. I love working on various different projects. So the main project that I'm working on at the moment is called Milk for Tea. The company's mission is, it aims to combat male suicide. We aim to get into the male community and work alongside men to find their identity, recognise their value and live out their purpose. That's the main mission. Social media for me is, so I actually took a break from social media for about 2 months after we launched, and it was the best thing that I ever did. I think social media for, in the current day is so prominent in everyone's life. Like, you wake up and you flick the phone up and, you look on social media, and it's creating such a lifestyle and such a lifestyle that isn't really that achievable. I mean, your Instagram's your highlight reel, really, isn't it? So I think the age group that I worry about so much now is like from, say, like 13 to 16, 17, because, you see all these guys, you see Cristiano Ronaldo driving his Bugatti around, then, kids want to be like that. Like, when I was growing up, I just wanted to be like Michael Owen, scoring a goal in, the 98 World Cup. That's kind of, and now it's like really, really, the aesthetic of it is what people are after, rather than the, the depth of emotion. So, and I also think, like, it's really sad to see, when people go out and eat dinner and everyone's on their phone, like, actually have conversation. Like, your phone isn't going to help your mental health, but people around you will. Yeah, well, it's hugely important, I'm sure. I mean, so I have a lot of Swedish friends who I value dearly, and a lot of them were affected by Avicii's suicide. And there was a Swedish documentary that was produced probably 3 months before he committed suicide, and it was kind of a cry for help, but no one really realised because of who he was and how he acted and how successful he was. So I think, everyone is going through some kind of stuff, and we really need to be mindful of the levels on how people value what they're going through. So as an example, someone who is suffering from low level anxiety, that might be a massive thing for someone else. And I think celebrities making it more known that they do go through this stuff. Like, I was speaking to my dad yesterday about Jose Mourinho and how he's making his players feel. Like, I wouldn't like to be in that dressing room, and I'm sure that I'd be affected by it. And I had managers when I was 13, 14, when we lost cup final, swearing at me. Like, that's kind of, I know what that environment's like. So people need to not tuck it away, not hide it, be, and then it'll promote young men to really want to, like, investigate and explore what these things mean. I was there the weekend that he died, and some of the things were awful, like the way that they reacted to it. And then the problem is when something like that, it triggers loads of other things. So then they thought it was their fault and their responsibility, and it triggers their mental health. Like, there's a lot of different things. Then you go into like coping mechanisms. It's like a downward spiral just because of one thing that had been going on. Whereas someone went up to him and was like, mate, let's go and talk about your mental health. Like, what things can we put in place to move you forward? Like, I said to one of them, I would have loved to have spoke to him just on that level and gone and maybe took him through like a coaching model, where I was like, okay, so like, what is it that you're facing now, and where do you want to be, and then what can we do to get you there? Like, it's not rocket science, but some people need that space to be held for them to just get it all out. He wanted to commit suicide when he was 13. He was bullied for a long, he said that he was labelled things that he didn't even know what they meant